Welcome to the second episode of Cucina Kouzina. Today we'll be making Spanakopita spinach pie. My recipe is a healthier recipe than some of the ones that you've seen. I use less butter and I use egg beaters as well. So let's get started. Now what I use is spinach. This is organic spinach, which has been, I use the frozen spinach. It's organic and I drain it. So I make sure that it's drained. Now some people use something called lita, which are amaranth leaves. You can find them in Asian markets. It's called Chinese spinach. Or there's Jamaican recipes that it's the pronunciation is kalalu. So some people use those spinach alternatives, if you'd like. So again, for my recipe, I'm using a 9 by 13 inch pan, which is a smaller pan than I use for the recipe that's in the cookbook. So what I have here is 24 ounces of the organic spinach. And I'm going to add to that one chopped scallion, organic, a little bit of dill. I use some dried dill, but if it's a teaspoon of dried dill. If you use fresh dill, make sure that you wash it and chop it up, and it's a one teaspoon. And then added to that, I use olive oil instead of the butter inside the mixture itself. And that's a 1/4 cup of the mixture, of the olive oil, sorry. Then added to that, because there is a little bit of moisture still in the spinach, I use a little bit of farina. You can use how much you want, as much as you want, but I use about 1/4 cup for this. And then added to that are the egg beaters, 8 ounces, and you're going to shake it. And then add that and leave a little bit at the end, because we're going to put that on top of the phyllo before we put it into the oven. And of course, the pièce de dessert, the feta cheese. Now, I have a pound here, but I'm not going to use all of it. I'm going to use about 3/4 of that. Then you mix that up. And over here, I've melted 1 stick of Kerrygold butter. And I use that just to use it for the phyllo, so that you can spread the butter between the sheets. So you're going to mix this up. We're going to put the ingredients that we're not going to use anymore over here. And you can mix this up. Make sure you give it a good mix. The spinach and the amaranth leaves, if you're going to use the vlita, they're high in antioxidants, high in vitamin K. And that's very good for you. Okay, I think we have. Now, if you want to use a little bit more of the feta, if you're a feta fiend, you can use that. You can use a little bit more. And now, what I'm going to do is, with clean hands, I have what you're going to use is a phyllo. It's called choriatico. It's a thicker phyllo than you would use for the baklava. And you can get that at any supermarket, Whole Foods, a Greek specialty store, market basket. And that what I'm using here is one from one of the Greek specialty stores. It's a little big for this pan. So I am going to see, you don't want it to tear like that. So you're gonna take this out. I'm not really fond of this particular filo, but we're gonna use what we have. So what we're going to do next is it's very simple to make spinach pie. You're going to take the butter and use your pastry brush and butter the bottom and the sides of the pan. Again, this is a 9x13 square pan. The recipe that I have in the cookbook, the Philoctetus cookbook, is a larger pan. It's a huge round pan. It's about 18 inches. So when you use, that's why the recipes are, you'll see when you go to the cookbook, it'll be a little bit larger. Okay, now for this one, they have film on every single one. I'm not fond of that, but so what you're going to do is you're going to take the filo and you're going to butter it. And because this is a large sheet of filo, I am going to play it by ear here. So we're going to take the pan, and this is a very thick, so you're going to place it in the pan as so. Now you're going to have a lot of the dough hanging out, but what I usually do is tuck it under. For this type of dough, I'm not going to do that. So if you have the choriatico, if you use the Contis or some of the brands that are at the that are in Market Basket, you can take the dough and place it underneath. So you just keep doing this. I'm going to put a couple. Now you want to count the number of sheets that you have. So for this particular brand, I have 1, 2, 3. I have only 3 left. So this is not going to allow me to do a whole lot with it. So I am going to put one more layer. On the bottom, because you need to have a little bit of a crust. Actually goes a little quicker. And you're gonna place it as so. Try to make sure you drape it so that you don't poke holes in the bottom. Okay. So the next thing you're going to do is use some of the mixture. And put that mixture all the way around the pan. Make sure you get the corners. And the sides. So it looks like with this particular, and It depends on what brand you're using and how much leaves of phyllo they have when you're actually making this. So the baklava recipe was a little bit more standard. This one is not. So I am going to fill this up, spread it out a little bit. Okay, next layer. So it's sort of like making a little lasagna with spinach and cheese. These are very popular, the spinach pies, the baklava, the pasticho, are very popular. The domades, which are the grapevine leaves, are very popular during the festivals, which there are several going on right now. We're filming this in the spring, in June, so we've had about one festival a week. Okay. So for this one, because I have to finish placing the mixture in the pan here. Okay, cover this up. Whatever you have. Oh, we were just talking about Julia Child when we have little mistakes like this. So just take a couple from the end and then put it in there so that you're not. You don't have any holes. Okay, next, you're gonna finish it up with the rest of the mixture. Don't worry about how much you're using or where it is, it's gonna spread in the oven. Okay, for the last, for the top, I'm gonna spread butter mixture. And we'll leave, be as generous as you can. Yeah, when I talked about the blita, which are the amaranth leaves, we used to go, when I was little, I used to go and pick them with my grandmother, my mother, friends of the family, my aunt. It's really a weed. It's a mountain green. And we used to go pick them out in the side of the road. And also, they used to grow in between we live in Chelmsford, so there are a lot of farms, and they have the corn. When they're growing the corn, the amaranth grows in between the corn, or at least when they planted it. I don't know whether the farmers used that specifically, or it was just wild. But amaranth leaves are used by several different cultures. As I said, Jamaica, Caribbean, Central America, and it's apparently they go back to 8,000 years ago with the Inca and the Aztec and the Maya, but they actually used the grain. And I mean, I'm sure they ate the leaves as well, but on the research that I did, they really use the amaranth grain, and I think you see that in several of the health food stores. Okay, so now we're done. So if I turned this under, it would be very, very thick on the bottom. So what I'm going to do is a little different. I'm going to make this like a little pie, and I'm going to fold this since I don't have a lot for the top. And I'm going to fold it on top, because usually you have about maybe 4 or 5 leaves for the topping. Okay. I hope that's not too thick in the corner. Yeah, it's going to be. So I'm going to take some of that, throw it away. Okay, now you're going to take the rest of the butter. And pour it on top. Make sure you get it all the way through. Okay, now leave a little bit of the butter and use the rest of the egg. Pour it in there and mix it up. Okay, now you're gonna go over it again. Try to get it through all of that so you don't have scrambled eggs on top. So this is a little bit, the egg beaters or egg whites, whatever your favorite brand is, you can use. If you want to use the high fat, you can use the, you can make it with eggs. The equivalent to what I, so the egg beaters, it's a half a carton, which is 8 ounces. Just keep mixing it up. Okay, so you're going to put this in a 350 degree oven for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, you're going to take it out, place foil with the shiny side down, put it back in the oven for another 30 minutes so it can cook the layers in between. Then take it out, remove the foil, and then you can put it in the oven for about 5, 15, or 20 minutes depending on your oven. I mean, even though you say 350 degrees, all other ovens are different, and depends if it's electric or gas. Electric cooks faster than gas. And then we're gonna break, we're gonna take it out, and then you'll see the finished product. I'll have it cut and plated. My passion for cooking started when I was a child. My earliest memories were cooking kouzina, Greek sesame cookies, with my mother and my grandmother. Over the years, I've cooked for co-workers, friends, and family, and even started a little business called Aphrodite's Confection when I was in my 20s. As I ease into retirement, I'm introducing Cucina Kouzina, a cooking show which is a tribute to my Greek and Italian heritage. We'll be making baklava, spanakopita, pasticcio, which is known as a Greek lasagna, a vegetable Italian lasagna. I'll even be tweaking a few of my yaya's recipes with more healthier ingredients. Some of my recipes are in the Holy Trinity Ladies Philoptophos Greek cookbook. I think you're going to really like Cucina Kouzina, so let's get cooking.
Awesome, that was really great.
There you have it, the spinach pie. It's a very simple recipe. I took it out of the oven, I cut it, let it cool, cut it into squares, and put it in some little baking cups. You can serve it as an appetizer, or when you do take it, you can serve it either cold or hot. If you want to use it for dinner or a light lunch, you can just cut the squares a little bit bigger, and you can serve it with rice pilaf, quinoa. If you're strapped for time, you can take, you can use some of those pre-made quinoa and rice mixtures that you can just take those pouches in 90 seconds, warm them up in the microwave and serve it that way, and you can have a nice little light lunch. You can even have a salad along with it. So thank you for tuning in to the second episode of Cucina Kouzina. And thank you, and looking forward to more episodes. Thank you very much.